Stuck inside during the apocalypse? Let's figure out what kind of games you might be into. Today, we're going to explore why you play games. There's no one unifying answer to why anyone plays games, but it's worth knowing why we spend $60 on pixels. A little while ago on my podcast, I called Pokemon the Star Wars of video games. I said this because it's a series that anyone can enjoy. By the way, check out Star Town Radio. I swear I'll start recording something for those again. Anyways, while I would probably update the statement because, at this point Star Wars fans aren't even a fan of Star Wars, I stand by the fact I consider Pokemon the video game for everyone. But why would we play Pokemon when we can just watch it? And for that matter, why do we play games in general? Sure, you can answer you play games for the story or the escapism or even just simple entertainment, but those are answers you can give to watching TV or listening to music. What's a unique reason you choose to play games instead of watching a movie? Well, the easy answer is agency. Watching a movie is passive consumption, whereas playing a game is active consumption. I feel like that makes sense when you say it, but when we recount these experiences, it's clear just how fundamentally different games are from other media. Bruh, it was so dope when Captain America shield surfed down the hill and he punched Thanos in Endgame. Oh my god, the buildup to the beat drop was so sick. Like, Mr. Skrillex, he like really knows how to put emotions into his music. It's all third person. But with video games, you recount the experiences in first person.
So this Richter had me on the ropes, just harassing me with projectiles. But somehow I managed to trick him into approaching, and I broke his shield. Twice.
Having an active hand in the game's narrative is a huge factor in why we play games. But even that's pretty all-encompassing and doesn't get into the deeper psychology of why we play games, especially when there's so many different types of games. There's a bunch of different ways to understand and categorize the psychographics of a game audience. Alright, now let's back it up and make sure we're all on the same page about what audience grouping is. There are four main ways marketing teams will typically segment their audiences: behavioral, geographic, demographic, and psychographic. I'll briefly talk about demographic, but our key focus is psychographics. Personally, I'm not a fan of categorizing through demographics. It's things like gender, age, or race. It's a great place to start to understand an audience, but if it's not critically looked at, it can end up being a short-sighted analysis. Maybe even racist, sexist, or homophobic. Psychographics are way more interesting to me. On a surface level, these are your interests. You know, things like sports, dancing, Italian plumbers. But we all know we're much more complex than that. If we're looking at you, the audience member slash gamer, I would start by looking at Bartle's taxonomy of player types. Bartle categorizes players into four groups: killers, achievers, explorers, and socializers. Let's go through these one by one. Killers want to best other players within the game. They seek enjoyment through competition, and by extension, a level of mastery of that game. In games like Pokemon, mastery means having a comprehensive knowledge and applying that knowledge to form a winning strategy. Achievers want to complete the goals of the game. This is the player type that will find satisfaction in crossing things off a checklist. Achievement can be found in simple acts, from beating the bosses and reaching the credits, to collecting collectibles, to completing every conceivable task designed within the game. Explorers want to experience the full breadth of the game, to discover what the world has to offer, whether that be Easter eggs and secret goodies, or just to answer the question, what happens if I do this? Socializers are interested in relationships with other players. They drift toward games with communities that prioritize friendship and teamwork. They like the act of playing with people and not against them. They find joy in expressing themselves to other players. And if the game doesn't inherently enable communication, socializers will find a way to bridge that gap. Now with these player types, Bartle put together a nifty graph to chart players' interests within a game. Killers enjoy acting upon other players. Achievers enjoy acting upon the world. Socializers enjoy interacting with other players. And explorers enjoy interacting with the world. So where do you fall on this chart? Personally, I consider myself an explorer. I definitely enjoy all four types of game indulgence, but I sit comfortably in the explorer category. I love to test mechanical theories and find hidden secrets. It's not perfect, but I really like Bartle's method of psychographic grouping. It revolves around player action and agency, which, like I said, it's the core tenet of what makes games a unique media. And while Pokemon isn't the only game to appeal to all four of these player psychographics, The needs of killers, achievers, socializers, and explorers are all acknowledged in a Pokemon. And they're done in a way that doesn't make any one group feel like they're just side content. Their goals constantly intersect throughout the game. Socialization benefits achiever goals. Collection achievements add knowledge and therefore mastery to the game. Mastery of the game enables exploration, and explorers are rewarded with social opportunities. I know I describe these relationships in a cyclical support system, but in reality it's an interconnected web. I'm not going to show you all these relationships because I think you get it. Anyways, Bartle's taxonomy of player types is just one way to understand and categorize player interest groups. I like it because it focuses on player action, but there are other great psychographic ways to define the audience. LeBlanc's taxonomy of game pleasures focuses on joy and pleasure, which can get a lot more specific. Players can find joy in all sorts of different ways, like conquest, expression, or even gift giving. Combining these two methods can help further sort out player experience. And if you're a game developer listening, I highly encourage you to do this. Not because every game needs to be satisfying to everyone, but because understanding the key appeal will make the experience that much more cohesive. Most games have a hard focus on one or two categories, like how Celeste is great for killers, but in focusing on that player archetype, made an experience that is also super satisfying for explorers as well. Animal Crossing is mostly a game for achievers, but a lot of this game revolves around socializer gameplay. Quick side note. Another really fun thing I found in my research is how people find ways to make a game fit their archetype needs. There's a YouTuber who goes by AlphaRed, who's primarily known on the internet to play killer type games like Smash Bros. He found a way to include competitive killer type aspects in Animal Crossing. It's super great to see players find creative ways to make a game fit their needs. Anyways, back on track. Some games like Pokemon will hit all of those player categories intentionally, so there's going to be a bunch of different ways players can enjoy a game. Now that's not to say Pokemon is the best game, but just that four people can enjoy the same game for completely different reasons. Knowing what you like about games helps you, the player, make informed choices about what games you want to buy, or how to find fun in a game that seems like it's not for you. Anyways, backing it up one last time, I'm an explorer, and I'm genuinely curious what you are, so let me know in the comments below what group you fall under. And while you're at it, list some games that you love to play that fall under these categories. We're all sheltering in place, staying safe, so you know, let's take this opportunity to find some new games to play. And that's my obligatory call for channel engagement at the end of the video. So, you know, thanks again for watching, see y'all next time. Stay safe, stay inside, and wash your damn hands. Please. So, I've been playing a lot of Animal Crossing recently. Mostly doing like fashion patterns and designs and stuff like that. I should do a fashion runway show or something like that. That'd be fun. Maybe when I have a few more designs all finalized and stuff. You know what? I'll talk to you later. I'm gonna go do that right now. Bye-bye.